Hey, it's Brad Petersen. I've been a friend of Doberman Dan's for a number of years now, and he asked me to make a little video for you budding copywriters. I've been a copywriter for about 20 years. I've worked with many of the big mailers, including Phillips Publishing, Agora Inc., Weiss Publishing. I've worked with some big-name gurus like Clayton Makepeace and Jay Abraham and Gary Halbert when he was alive. So I've been around the block a few times and have had some experience, and Dan thought it might be useful for me to share a couple of tips. So today I thought, you know, I'll pick something that's been one of my big challenges as a copywriter, and maybe yours too, and that is dealing with this whole problem of procrastination. Whenever you get an assignment, it comes in and you find yourself putting it off or not doing it, and then trying to get it done in just a couple of days because the client's breathing down your neck. And I just wanted to give a couple of tips on how I try to deal with these kind of things. And my first one is something I learned from working with Clayton Makepeace. He drilled into me was, do the easy stuff first when you start an assignment, which means start doing your research, start reading the other promotions, read the competitors' stuff, get this stuff percolating in your mind. Even if you're not ready to commit to the project, maybe you're finishing up another project, get your subconscious started on it just by reviewing what it's all about. So you're not working. There's no resistance to what you're doing. All you're doing is reading a little, putting down some ideas on paper. You're not writing headlines. You're not writing copy. So your mind is not putting up this resistance of, oh, I've got to do a great job, or, oh, if the client doesn't like my copy, I'm going to, you know, my career is doomed. All these things we use in our minds to create anxiety that cause us to procrastinate. And so when you get an assignment, just get started on something like that so you get your subconscious percolating while you're working on something else. So don't put things off. The easy stuff off. The second one is another problem that's been a special problem of mine is I tend to overestimate how much work I can get done in a day. So I'll start calculating, oh, I can work 8 hours on that project on Tuesday. And never in my life did I actually then work the 8 hours. I worked 3 hours, I worked 4 hours, or whatever it was. So you need to determine, you know, how many hours can you realistically get done in a day? And yeah, you put that in your calendar, but there's one added thing, and that is to schedule, regardless of how busy you are, regardless of how important what you're working on is, schedule what one of my favorite authors, a guy named Neil Fiore, calls guilt-free play, where in your schedule you put in things that are breaking up your day. So you're not looking forward to a day of, oh my God, I got to write for 8 straight hours, which you're not going to do anyway. So you might as well say, okay, I'm going to write for an hour, or I'm going to write for an hour and a half, or maybe the famous Eugene Schwartz 33 minutes. And then you schedule some fun thing in there that you're going to do as a reward, but also as a motivator of, okay, I'm not looking at a big block of time I got to work. I'm going to read a good book. I'm going to go to the movies. I'm going to go hang out with my friends. So it's part of your schedule. It's not just something that comes up. And this sort of takes some of the overwhelming nature of a big project off your mind. It's not suddenly, oh, I got 50, 60, 70, 80 hours of work ahead of me. You know, you've got a few hours of work, and then you've got a few hours of play. And for more on that concept and a lot of other great ideas for fighting the procrastination demons, I'm going to recommend to you Neil Fiore's book. It's called The Now Habit. It's absolutely my favorite book of all time on fighting procrastination. And I got to tell you, I've read a ton of them. So anyway, that's what I've got for you today. I hope you found it helpful. If you want to learn more about me or get more tips from me, you can always go to my blog, which is at bradpetersen.com, and that's Petersen with an E, bradpetersen.com, and occasionally I'll be sharing more of these kind of things. But I want to thank Doberman Dan for the opportunity to be here, and I hope you found it helpful. Talk to you soon.